Do you want to get paid and work as a professional DIT on a 360 VR film set or commercial? Welcome to our brand new series on becoming a VR DIT, hosted by Matthew from Lifestyle VR. If you don't know Matthew, he is the VR wizard behind the recent 360 commercial for Adidas and many more Hollywood level VR production. In this series, we will cover what a professional DIT is, how to build a DIT card with a custom-built computer and light monitoring system. We will showcase how to shoot with the Blackmagic 12K to create 12K 360 video with the best image quality. We will talk about media management, such as offloading and backing up your media safe and fast. We will even talk about TouchDesigner, STMap, PTGui for light monitoring within a VR headset like the Oculus Quest 2. And most importantly, a VR DIT is there to help the cinematographer, help the director, and help all the stakeholders who have a creative say in the project to make sure what you capture on set is something that everyone loves. This is why having a capable VR DIT on set is so important. And we will teach you how in 3 separate video tutorials. Let's dive right in.
So what is a DIT? A DIT stands for Digital Imaging Technician, but really what that translates to is someone on set who collaborates with the director and the cinematographer and other stakeholders to showcase what is on the camera and display it in a format that people can creatively collaborate with. So typically, in a digital workflow, which is what the Digital Imaging Technician stands for, cameras these days shoot in a flat log profile. Everything's really flat, the colors are all off, right? If you look at that on set, you wouldn't have any idea whether it's exposed properly, whether the colors are correct. So your DIT takes that image, applies what's called a LUT or a lookup table, does some sort of color correction to that, right? And displays the image out so that the client, so that the director, so that the cinematographer can be looking at an image that's not the final grade, but in the right color space, right? Because a lot of these cameras shoot in what's known as a log color format. And you want to translate it into something called a Rec. 709 color format. Now in VR, we've got a couple of really interesting challenges. Many 360 cameras don't really offer a great way to view what you're actually seeing. And it's not like you can stand necessarily behind the camera all the time and also view it. So it presents some interesting, you know, problems. On the Blackmagic 12K, one of the amazing things is it contains all of the professional outputs one would need to actually build a professional DIT setup. And that's what I've built. So what I expect a DIT on my set to do is to be able to take the feed, take the fisheye footage, wrap it to equirectangular, and then wrap it again to rectilinear. So equirectangular is, of course, the 360 degree, like flat map view, right? And rectilinear is taking this spherical fisheye and making it like the 2D image. And hopefully, and what I've tried to do is match, like for example, YouTube's 360 field of view, although that can be changed. So one of the apps that I use to do that on this machine is called TouchDesigner. And there's a couple things that you need here on TouchDesigner. So one of the first things you need to do is you need to bring your video signal in. So from the camera, I've got an SDI out, it is going into the Blackmagic 12K on the computer and into TouchDesigner. And that is my fisheye image, okay? And if I was to put that on this monitor, it would look kind of like this. This cable is SDI, goes out of the camera and into the Blackmagic 8K decklink card and into TouchDesigner, and the raw signal is the fisheye, and that's what's on the screen right here, right? So this is the HAL 250. It's 250 degrees, edge to edge horizontal, and you can see it clips on the top. So it's about 203 degrees on top. At least that's what I've calculated out. So it's fair good. It's enough overlap to definitely stitch it. So what we want to do as a DIT is we need to take this image, which looks nothing like the final product, and turn it into something that actually makes sense. And the way we do that is by using something called an STMap. These can be generated. There are these like green and yellow and red maps, and these can be generated using Andrew Hazelden's Carta VR tools. Bless that man. He is just a genius and a gem of a human being. And that'll take our fisheye lens and unwrap it into our equirectangular. So we'll end up with something that looks like this, right there. And I think this is flipped, so let me unflip that. There we go. So now we see it in the spherical format. And that's pretty awesome, because now we can see everything that's being acquired in a format that's traditional to how we would see it in the edit page, right? Seeing it all at once. Yes, it's still distorted, but you know, everything's a little bit easier to see. But this isn't really what the final's gonna look like. So what I expected DIT to do is also to take that and to unwrap that. And this is why TouchDesigner is so great. So we'll take our spherical image that we have here, and what we're gonna do is we're gonna project it on the inside of a 3D sphere. Same thing that you do inside like a video rendering engine, right? And then we're gonna put our camera inside that sphere right in the center that looks at it so we can see our texture. And when all that is hooked up, what we have is this. Right now this is looking into the wall, right? But I've built in a handy slider here that allows me to move back and forth and see and pan around just like I would on YouTube, for example. And this field of view right now is currently set up to be similar to YouTube. It's not 100%, but again, you're just trying to get in the ballpark. It's pretty good. A couple of other things to note. On the Blackmagic camera itself, it is recording flat, it's recording log. You do want to make sure that in the menus here, you go over to the monitor function and display your 3D LUT. That's really important, because if you see it off, it's very, very flat, but I can go ahead and put the display LUT on, and now I've got my color balance stuff. There's so much more you can still do with this. We're really at the start of just exploring this, but this system's been working really well for me. Now, you'll notice I also have the Sumo monitor here. What is so fantastic about this is that I can go ahead and hit record on the take as the actors are happening, and it'll record right to this SSD right in here. So if I click record there, the actors do all the stuff. Here, I'm gonna bounce over here. There's my boy Hugh doing a great job. And then when we go here and hit stop, I can then immediately jump to playback. And that's really phenomenal, because now I can see what that last take was on YouTube, and I can show the stakeholders on set, and I can show the director, and I can show anybody that needs to make a creative decision about that last take without needing to bring it into the computer, to stitch it, to run it through Mystica, which is great and does give you a great experience, but it also takes time. However, that is the second part of what a DIT does. So monitoring on set, I think, is really important for VR DIT. Some people might argue that a VTR technician is more like the proper role for that. But I think that getting the image to look the way people need to see it is part of what a DIT in VR should do. The second part, of course, is managing media. Blackmagic, what I love about it is it's got one SSD, super fast, USB-C, it's 1,000 megabytes per second read write, right? And that very, very quickly can go onto some hard drives to be backed up on. But not all cameras are like that. Let's take like the Titan, there's 8 SD cards. Let's take the Yi Halo, 17 micro SD cards. Your VR DIT needs to be able to manage all that data and bring it in and work with it quickly. I was on a job, we were shooting on Zcam S1, 4 cards, director wanted to see stuff right away, had my 4-card SD reader, popped in all 4 cards, Very fast transfer, brought it in, stitched it, was able to show something in under an hour. Now, I know it sounds like a pretty long time, but for all that work, it's not that much. And I think a VR DIT needs to understand the stitching process and be confident enough to do that. Here's a really important point to understand if you want to get into being a VR DIT. You need to understand what a USB bus is, right? So yes, you have maybe 12 USB ports on this particular motherboard, but you only really have two USB buses, right? And that's gonna share 500 megabytes per second of bandwidth, right? So if I have SD cards that are like 10 SD cards, suddenly my rate of transfer for each of those SD cards is only 50 megabytes per second. And that's really much slower than I wanna be. So by adding USB cards, by using super fast SSD hard drives, you can now offload media a lot faster. A lot of times people just think like, ah, Thunderbolt, ah, USB-C, oh, that's fast, oh. And they forget to look at like, well, what is the media that you're offloading to? Because the maximum read-write speed of your media is typically your bottleneck. And then after that, it becomes, well, are you saturating your bus? What's the maximum read-write speed of the actual bus? And in the case of USB, you've got a total of 3.0, you've got 5 gigabytes per second. So then you can just start doing some basic math, right? About, well, how many cards am I gonna offload? What cameras are they coming with? What are the sizes of the cards? And how fast does that need to offload onto a drive and be backed up to another drive? On set, you wanna use certain tools to back up your media from your cards. The tool that I use the most is called Hedge. I like Hedge because it's really fast. It does do checksum verification. I find it a little bit faster than like ShotPut Pro, which does a very detailed checksum verification. But Hedge is great, and it can copy your one card to two hard drives at a time, which definitely saves you a bunch of energy. So how do you generate this STMap? That could be a tutorial in and of itself, but you need to understand how PTGui works. PTGui is another tool that VR DITs need to understand because they need to understand how to take a fisheye lens from any VR camera, unwrap it, and stitch it together to generate something like this. Once you can generate these ST maps, you now have a real custom way to be able to do live previews like this, to be able to work in DaVinci Resolve, to do like color correction with the Carta VR toolset. So that I think is pretty important. Okay, so we've gone through a whole bunch of stuff. We built a DIT cart with a custom built computer. We have a monitoring situation. We have a Blackmagic 12K with my 250 lens. And we've talked about how a VR DIT needs to not only be, you know, your downloader of media and backing up all that stuff, but also really needs to be able to understand and handle the image on set. And all of this was born out of necessity because I had clients asking me for things, for solutions that weren't invented yet, right? Or that I didn't have an off-the-shelf answer for. So, you know, when a client says, hey, what is this gonna look like on YouTube? It's not really acceptable to take it from the card, stitch it together, upload it to YouTube, and wait for it to process in order to answer that question. They wanna know now on set. So by using TouchDesigner and by using a rig like this, we can throw up an image right on the monitor here that has the same field of view and the same unwrapping as YouTube. So that way they can see, for example, what's my starting frame? You know, we just did a recent project with Adidas, and that was really important because they brought up an excellent question. Hey, this is living on .com, it's on the web. People are viewing this mainly on their desktop computers. What happens if they don't click and interact with it? What's the default frame? And that way we could view everything on set and assure people that yes, the head height is really good. Yes, the spacing of all the women is appropriate. Hey, everything that we want in frame, if no one were to touch it, is perfect. And that is what a DIT is there to help do. It's there to help the cinematographer, it's help the director, and help all the stakeholders who have a creative say in the project to make sure that what you're capturing on set is something that everyone loves. because that's the goal, right?
Thank you for watching episode 1 on how to be a professional VR DIT. Next episode, we will cover the Blackmagic 12K workflow and how to build Matthew's DIT card. We will give you a list of hardware to build in the most cost-effective way. In episode 3, we will talk about light monitoring inside the Oculus Quest 2 on set using Oculus Air Link. TouchDesigner, NDI, and Matthew's free Unity software. So don't forget to subscribe to Creator Up, hit the notification bell. If you need more help on professional DIT workflow, how to use SharpPut Pro to backup, how to manage media for Insta3C Titan, Kendall Obsidian Pro right here, or the Insta3C Pro 2, then you need to check out our 360 VR Filmmaking Masterclass, link right here. I need your feedback. If you want to invite Matthew back to our 360 VR Filmmaking Masterclass and learn how to create STMap and DWARP any fisheye with PTGui retail, comment below and let us know what kind of professional workflow you want to learn so we can create them for you. We want to support anyone who wants to become a 360 VR filmmaker and tell your story in VR. I hope to see you in my masterclass or see you on a professional film set. Ciao. Maya Angelou famously said, "People will forget what you said, people will forget what you did, but people will never forget how you make them feel." The ability to make your audience feel love or hate, joy or despair, fear or enjoyment had never been more at our fingertips than now with virtual reality 360 storytelling. If you have ever wondered how to make a film, documentary or fictional piece using this new medium that creates an emotional impact, a feeling that they will never forget, then please come join me as it is my mission to give you this power to touch, to inspire, and to create. In this 360 VR Filmmaking Masterclass, we will give you a framework to work from as a storyteller or filmmakers using your familiar language. No matter what your skill level is in immersive production, you can take away a wealth of knowledge from some of the world's leading experts in the field. We will cover practical topics like fundraising, client communication, budgeting, scripting and storyboarding, directing, blocking, set and space design, camera and shooting, lighting, spatial audio, DIT, stitching and editing, and even distribution in the entire VR filmmaking ecosystem. I hope this course will serve as your go-to guide on VR filmmaking, so you can go out there and create. No matter if you are a VR producer, director, camera operator, or VR enthusiast.